Hi everyone and welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to show you Jules. This is how beautiful their landing page looks like. Like again, now very simply, like if you have to understand, this is made for developers, right? This is not made for like, you know, vibe coding or stuff. This is actually made for developers. And I'm going to show you the demo. I got an early invite and it looks really good, right? Okay. So what I'm going to do is I just want to make sure that everyone can understand how Jules work and what is the whole idea behind this. But very simply, it's a big competition to what OpenAI released. It's called Codex. They've been able to do something super quick. So if you're getting inside, just click connect to GitHub, right? And give access to your GitHub account. And once you have access, you can select which repositories it applies to or all repositories. I'm just going to do all installing and authorizing. And give me a second. I'm going to put in the password. Okay, perfect. Logged in. And now you can see this is where you get into, right? So you are just starting on to a chat. And the only thing that you have to do is select a repo. Yep, you can select a repo here. You can see the multiple options right now. I'm choosing something simple. This is one thing I created. It's a simple website called Apex Leadership. The name of this repo is Green Leaf Leadership, right? I want to show what it looks like to actually use this. As you can see, these are called branches. If you're not using GitHub before, it's something new. So what I want to do is I have this website, but it's all dark mode, right? Can you work on adding a light mode also in the website? I'm not putting in a massive prompt or something. I just want to start with the plan. As you can see, it is going to set up a plan. The best thing here is this particular command called booting up the VM. What happens with Jules and how does this differ from all the vibe coding that we are doing is this technically does not need me to sit here. I can just go ahead, come back, and once I click the next step, go ahead. I don't need to see anything. The problem with Lovable and all of these things is that you have to keep doing and then you see what's happening here, changing, but that doesn't change anything. I still have to be in front of the computer. I can just come back and it's already going and understanding my rep, and that's pretty much it. I can just leave, come back after doing something. I can even close this window and be okay with this. You see, it has given a great plan. The best thing is you can understand what it's going to change, what it's going to add, and everything else. Now, as an engineer, you would go ahead and deep dive into, like, you know, what does the plan look like? Ask it if you want to change something, and you can do that. Right now, I'm just going to click on approve plan. And as you can see, it auto approves in 4 minutes, 33 seconds, right? Now, because I gave the task, I'm not supposed to wait here to click the button. I could have just gone, but we are going to click approve the plan. And it has already started working on it. And the point is, there is no demo coming up. There is nothing on, like, you know, seeing as a thing, because it's just working on it. It's really just working on it in its own environment, and that's the most beautiful part. Now, that does make for us, like, you know, does not make very interactive video, but that's the idea. Even in Codex, the idea is that you can give it tasks and you come back to it. So right now you can see it's already working. I can also come to another repo, right? We can come here and search for something new. Let's say I choose something called Connect Media. So I have a code base where we have Connect Media, and I can create a new task, add a different way to manage CRM. So Connect Media is just a personal CRM and a different way to upload profile photos. I'm just going to make it simple. The best thing is I can click on give me a plan and then I can just walk away. I don't need to do anything. Like, I can just see, you can see recent task, remove this, and it's already working on them. You can see it's already working on them. Obviously right now the task limit is super low, right? But that's fine. Right, we are just going to come back here and it's going to keep working. It's going to keep working. And that's the beauty of Jules. Like, it will just automatically do it. But I just want to see how this ends up so I can show you how you actually finally merge this branch and bring that up to Jules. But the point being that this just changes the way we work with programs and we work with, like, you know, Lovable or anything. It's like too much. You need to be there. This is just engineering happening by telling it what needs to be done. Go ahead and figure it out and come back to me when you're done. Obviously, let's check on the limit. So right now it's like 5 code tasks per day, 3 concurrent tasks, 5 total tasks. I'll show you a couple of more features. You can obviously request for more limits and everything, and I've already applied for that. Let's see when we get access to that. But let's say come back to Jules, right? Now, another thing you have here is create a code cast, right? Now, very simply, creating a code cast is like kind of like you can select a code cast and create a kind of like a, like, you know, a podcast for your coding repo. So let's say we come here and then you can click here and, like, you know, you can generate this. Now, the only thing is, like, this is a very new shiny feature. I don't think a lot of people are going to use it. Engineers read a lot of code. They're not really meant to listen to podcasts about code. And I just want to hear, what does it come out to be, right? Like, that's pretty much it. Is it going to be a summary of the task? Is it going to be something like that? But given that it has episodes and everything, this is just their feature integration from what Notebook LM was doing and bringing it here. So that looks really cool, right? And also feels pretty cool that they're able to do this, but I'm just waiting to what it ends up at. Then obviously you can, like, you know, run this to test and everything else, but I just want to see what it comes out to be. And you can see the task progress also right now. It's doing a lot of things, and we can just, like, you know, I'm just going to, like, you know, and as you can see, this is the other part, right? This is where we were at. I'm just going to click on approve plan, and after that, this is just going to keep running, going to keep doing itself. And I just want to see how does the quality come out as an output. So we're going to fast forward this piece and see how it works. I'll tell you the cool part. I just went out and, like, you know, got some snacks and everything, but this is still running, and that's the whole idea. I don't need to be here. I can just leave, and I don't even need this window open. I'm just recording this video and showing this. This is how engineering will look sometimes. What do you think about that? I'm just going to leave it here. So very simply, it has done a couple of steps, and this is what it has done and finally come back with. And then I'm just going to write go ahead, right? Because I feel like it's pretty good, right? It created a whole theme and everything, and you can see all the changes that it has done, right? So you can see an updated components, uses new theme classes and everything else. And this is the theme provider, right? So this is another page that it created. Let's see what comes out, because then finally I need to merge it, and then I'm just going to show it. But as you can see, there was another task that we had, but is already still working on it, or actually did it. So this actually got completed, setting up the byte testing environment and everything else. Got it. And then you can see this is like a different branch. I can click on this, press publish, and then publishes a separate branch. Now, for all the people who don't know how GitHub works, let me bring you to GitHub and show repositories. I'm going to search for ConnectMedia. Once this is done, it's going to publish branch. And as you can see, it has added 268. And then you see there's another branch. You can create a new pull request and merge it all together. Click on this new branch. Perfect. As you can see, I can come here, compare, and create a pull request. Create a pull request. So pull request is just like it's pushing into the main branch together, right? Click on merge and confirm merge. Now it is automatically merged into my main branch. So why is this important? Is that AI will make mistakes, right? You are in control of what you're merging as a code, right? So you as an engineer are completely responsible for it's getting done. But let me just, like, you know, show you how the tech team org chart looks like, right? And I'll explain why this matters. This is going to second, because until this runs, right? So until this second task is done, I just want to show that. I know it's a bit out of scope of the video, but I'll just tell you what does this mean, right? If you see this particular image, very simply, you have an SD intern, which is someone who comes in from a university or something directly, and then you have SD1 and etc. Like, it's just levels to engineering. The point is, people at SD1 and, like, you know, intern level, or even at an SD2 level, would be writing a lot of this code, right? They'll have issues, fix them, and send them for review to SD3 and so on. The point is, this technically is able to solve problems at an intern level like that, right? So if you see, it has implemented a dark theme. I'm going to click on publish branch. Even the world's best minds are saying the same thing about how the entry-level engineering role is going to be, I think everyone is just going to become, I don't know, like a senior engineer on much more output, right? It's not going to be like, I don't know what looks like for a job perspective, but it's just going to be much easier. Okay, but come back here, able to merge, right? And then you click on create a pull request. Once you click on create a pull request, I'm not, you know, checking anything. As an engineer, if you're doing this on some live project, you obviously have to check every piece of code because there are so many other problems. But this is just cool. Like, you know, I did not need to sit here to do everything. And this is like something that now I think we have three options. So we have Codex, we have Jules, and then we also have Microsoft own GitHub Copilot agent, right? And we have the branch ready. If I come back to Lovable, I should be able to see a merge, yes. And then in here, we should have an option for dark mode or not. Let's see. Actually, let's give a refresh. After refreshing, you see this, and then you have a dark theme and a light mode. Now again, if you see, it did not do it perfectly well, but our prompt and explanation was also not great. The only thing it has missed is, you know, the text here is not changed from white. So you can see there is text here. It's just in white color, right? And this is where AI will make mistakes. So you have to make sure that you check it up and everything. But still, just from the perspective of quality that you are able to get in a single shot prompt, not even take care of it and see it where we are going. So this is Jules for you, right? Again, go ahead and try it out. I think they have sent out a lot of invites, but this is just great. This is Jules for you, right? Again, and let me see if we have our podcast. We have it. Let me switch on so that once it starts speaking.
Hey, you're welcome back to Jules Podcast Daily. Today, we're jumping straight into the Greenleaf Leadership Codebase. Some interesting stuff happening there. Our mission is to give you the quick rundown on recent changes. Keep you maintainers in the loop.
Exactly. And what really stands out this time is a whole new landing page for their leadership program. The commit literally says, create landing page. Plus, there's a whole bunch of new component files added.
Also, a big piece of new functionality. What components are we seeing? What's first?
There's quite a mix. You've got CT section, TSX, that's your call to action, likely where they push for signups or maybe consultations. Seems like they thought about different user journeys right away.
Yeah, looking at the code. Ready to transform your leadership journey.
So honestly, this is crazy. I don't know if I want to know about every file name. I understand that it's very leading, it's very new. But this might help a lot of new engineers to get you up to speed on a code base that you're using for the first time, right? And like, you know, just allow you. I think they'll soon ask, like, you know, what you want to understand in massive code bases and then give you a podcast on that, right? So when you're going in, you are able to start to imagine a massive code base has a lot of dependencies and you can come back to that. I think this is super cool. I was not going to be like it again, but the quality, I know how they're able to do this with their notebook LM stuff. This is super cool, right? But that's Jules for you. If you are here for the first time, please do subscribe to the channel. It would really mean a lot to me and also really helps me out do more of these videos, right? My name is Akshat Bahety and I will see you in the next one.